All right, we have some very exciting music for you this morning. We have Ethan there and Gabriela over here, and they are members of the Young Artists, the San Diego Young Artists Symphony in San Diego. And we are very, very lucky to have them here playing for you this morning. Who can tell me what an orchestra is? Have you ever been to an orchestra or heard of orchestra music? Yes, I hear little girl in the red there. What is an orchestra? Right, right. An orchestra. I'm gonna raise this a little bit. See if I can raise this a little bit. Orchestra. You're right. It's a group of musicians that come together with all kinds of instruments to play music together. Playing in an orchestra is a big job, and it's very, very difficult. Because it's like trying to read this same book, all of us here, at the same time. It would be difficult if we don't know how fast to go or how slow to go. Same situation when you play in an orchestra. There's lots of musicians, and they all play different instruments. And they need to know when to start playing and when to stop playing. So Gabriela and Ethan play for a big orchestra in San Diego. Today, we have violin. They play the violin. Now, orchestra music can be very, very complex. It can be big, but it can also be very exciting. Have you ever gone to the movies? How many of you have seen a movie? All right, even at home, if you watch a movie or a DVD, have you ever paid attention to what happens when the things are happening on the screen? They don't just talk. There's music in the background. And the music makes the movie very exciting. And when the movie is exciting, the music gets loud. And when a movie is sad, you hear sad music in the background. So music can change our mood. It can make us happy, and it can make us sad, depending. So who knows who writes all this music? What is the name we call people that write the music? What do we call those people? A painter. Somebody that does the painting is called the painter. Somebody that makes a sculpture is called a sculptor. What do we call a person that writes music? Over here. Pretty close. She said a director, but he's not a director. In the back in the blue. He is definitely an artist, but there's a special name. Or with a colorful jacket. And what? A musician? A musician is actually a person that plays it. What we call the person that writes the music that you hear is a composer. A composer. A composer writes music. Just like an author writes books, a composer writes music. And it's very difficult to write music for 100 different instruments in an orchestra. Think about that next time you listen to music. So now that we have all the musicians in an orchestra and we have the music, who is in charge of making sure that everything does the right job? What do we call that person? Do you know what do we call the person? There's one person that stands at the very front of all the musicians. And he sometimes, it could be a he or she, sometimes looks really funny and goes something like this. What do we call him? Yes, a conductor, good job. A conductor has a huge job. Their job is to make sure that all the instruments play the right time, at the right tempo, the right beat. They have to make sure everybody stops and starts at the same time. It's like all of us trying to read the same music at the same book at the same time. And we all have to stop at the same time and start at the same time. We would need somebody to lead us, right? To say, 1, 2, 3, begin. Well, that's what his job is. He has a huge job. His job is also to interpret the music that the composer wrote. That means to sort of give it his own meaning. Is the music supposed to be exciting, or is it supposed to be quiet? Is it supposed to make us feel kind of inquisitive and mysterious, or is it supposed to make us feel sad? I don't know. That's what the conductor does. So this morning, we're very lucky because we're able to have two violinists from this orchestra in San Diego. And before we start playing music, I want to know if anybody here knows what kind of instruments do you find in the orchestra? Who can tell me some of the instruments you find over here? Definitely a violin. They're probably the most important instrument. Not just because I like violins, but because this sort of, they're the main part of the music over here. What other instrument? A what? A saxophone. Yes, you can have a saxophone in the back. You may have a piano sometimes, and when you do, it's usually a guest, and they're sitting in the very front, or they're sitting in the very front. Over here, what else? A tuba? Yes, you can have a tuba in the back. Yes? A trumpet, yes, those are the loud guys of the orchestra. Over here, what else do you find in an orchestra? A gong? Is that what you said? Yes, you have a gong on those big plates that you hit. Boom, very good. Over here, what else? A flute, yes, the flute plays a beautiful, sweet sound in the back. Clarinet, yes, all these wonderful instruments you can find in an orchestra. And just so you know, a big orchestra usually has four sections or four families. It's very important that you remember this. Next time you hear music or you go to the movies and you hear the music in the back, listen for these different sections. What do you think they are? The what section? The string section. What else? The percussion. I heard somebody said percussion. That's where your drums are. Very good. Somebody said trumpet. What do you think the trumpet section is called? It's called the brass section. Brass section. And then somebody mentioned a flute. The flute and the oboe and the piccolo, they belong to a section called the winds. Okay, who wants to hear music? You guys want to hear some music? I thought so. Why, you're so well behaved. I'm very impressed. Teachers done such a great job. Okay, we're going to start with a piece.